let us see one more type of your numerical, which is based on elevation and boiling point. So now again, same thing. As soon as a numerical is given to you, as soon as you see boiling point, that particular word, first try to write the formula. When you write the formula, you very well know what to substitute in that. So next we can go with the conversion of the units. So elevation and boiling point, I already said TB is equal to KB into M. In the earlier video, I've also derived this step by step. Previous video, please watch the previous video only. And when I have to finally find molecular mass, only thing you have to remember is KB by delta TB into W2 by W1. This is the basic formula. This is the most important formula for calculating molecular mass. I've also given you one formula for calculating relative lowering of vapor pressure, molecular mass. Here also the same thing. Remember this formula and go, because every numerical they will ask from this only. So let's come back and see. So I have to find, using that formula, let's write what data is given to us. Given data. Done. First important thing, let's see. Because they've asked to calculate the molar mass, both the formulas are ready. This is the formula for molar mass. Done. Let's see what is KB here. KB, that is your ebullioscopic constant. What is given to us? They've given KB for water as 0.6. Okay, 0.6 K by M. Done. Let's see for TB. Delta TB. What did they give me? They said the BP of water becomes 100.52 degree Itsems. It becomes, they said. That means there is elevation in what they've not given me exact value. That's going to, it will raise from 100 degrees to 100.52 degrees, they said. So TB they've given me, so delta TB is 100.52 degrees centigrade minus 100 degrees centigrade. I have to find here, that's only difference in the numerical. So take this out and you get subtract 0.52 degrees centigrade. So this is your delta TB. Now delta TB is also over. Now let me find out for W2. What did they give me? W2 is nothing but weight of solute always. Take solute weight as W2. What did they give me? They've given me 1.5 grams of non-volatile solute. So W2 is 1.5 grams. So I should also have W1. What is W1 given to me? Okay, here a bit different. They've given me 1.5 grams of non-volatile solute is dissolved in 100 ml of it. Nothing is given regarding the weight. Simple, isn't it? It is given in 100 ml. Volume is given to us. Not a problem. It's easy. Let's see. How can I do? Whenever volume is given to you, so we very well know. Okay, let us write first 100 ml. Density is equal to mass by volume. I want this mass, isn't it? Mass is equal to density into volume. Done. Volume is already there. So mass is equal to density of water is what? One isn't it? One gram. per centimeter cube. So density, careful, 1 gram per centimeter cube. Let us consider density of water as 1 gram. Yeah, 1 gram per centimeter cube. So this is your standard value of for water. So let us substitute instead of density 1 into what is the volume given to us is 100 ml. So this is a centimeter cube. Let us write now. This is centimeter cube, this is ml, so I can write it as 1 gram per ml also. Not a problem. Yes, because this is a volume is in ml, so 1 gram per ml. Let us take that 1 gram per ml. So hope you understood this. Density of water, value is 1 gram per ml. So this is also an ml. I'm writing as density is equal to 1 gram per ml into volume given is 100 ml. Okay, now see, ml and ml gets cancelled. What are you left with? 100 into 1. This is your 100 grams, okay, which is equal to 0.1 kg. Why did I write kg? Because I have to always consider the weight of the solvent in kg. So whenever volume is given to you, try to use this, convert it into 0.1 kg. Now substitute. M is equal to KB is there, it's 0.6 K by M. W2, weight of the solute 1.5 grams. Delta TB, what is delta TB given to us? Or we have got as 0.52 into this. W1, weight of solvent always should be in kg. Remember this, convert it in weight of solvent in kg only. So I've already got 0.1 kg. So when I solve this, yes, I'm going to get an answer of 17.9 gram per mole. This is your answer. So simple. 17.3, sorry, I'm sorry, 317.3 gram per mole. This is your answer. I've already solved it. I've given the answer here, 17.3 gram per mole. So important thing, as soon as you step one, as soon as a numerical is given to you, write the formula, because you can see, you know, boiling point formula is only two. One either this or one either this. Mostly they'll be asking you molecular mass. Okay, after writing the formula, write the given data, copy it from sum, and see whichever units you have to convert. You've converted, so directly substitute and find the answer. Important, write the units also.